Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Erica with Memory Box Candle Co. and I make videos all about making and selling candles. And real fast before I get into the video, my dog Brody is right under me right now and he keeps hearing the noises in my apartment complex and he keeps letting out little barks. So this is probably the sixth or seventh time I've tried to do this intro. So I apologize if you hear that throughout the video, but let's go ahead and get started. So today's video topic is going to be all about Alibaba. Now, if you're not too familiar with what Alibaba is, or if you have heard of it before and you've just been kind of a little bit nervous to order something from them, essentially what it is it's just a platform where buyers and sellers come together to do business. It's much like eBay and Etsy, to where it's a platform and you have buyers and sellers. The only difference is that on Alibaba, it is mainly for people looking to get a large quantity of one item and a wholesale discount. And the buyer is typically a business owner. Now, I personally was a little bit nervous myself to purchase something from Alibaba just because I didn't know how it worked. I didn't know where I was sending my money, who to trust, what suppliers to choose, how do I know if the product's gonna be good or not. And back when I was doing Amazon FBA, when I was around 22 years old, I actually had sent through PayPal $1,000 to a supplier on Alibaba to purchase a product to then resell on Amazon. And when I tell you guys that I was terrified when I hit the pay now button, I was terrified. I didn't know what was gonna happen. I was just hoping that I picked a good supplier, that I wasn't going to get scammed, and I was just hoping for the best, and everything worked out totally fine. And to be honest, I have no issues with purchasing from Alibaba at all. I love talking to suppliers, getting different pricing, and kind of understanding, you know, their business and what they have to offer. So I just wanted to help you guys out and give you a few tips. So the first tip that I have for you guys, just to ease any worries that you have about what suppliers to search for. So what I want you guys to do is whatever item you are searching for, in this example, we'll be searching for wick trimmers because I had these made quite a while ago and I have my little logo lasered onto them or however they did that. So what I want you guys to do is type in wick trimmers and you are able to actually go up into the right-hand corner of the app and click on refine. And that's essentially just how you can filter through certain things. Scroll all the way down and then click on the Alibaba Trade Assurance and the verified supplier. So now what you have done is you have filtered out all suppliers that do not accept payment through Alibaba Trade Assurance and who is not a verified supplier. So I will explain what all that means right now. So Alibaba Trade Assurance, for me personally, is the only way that I will do business with suppliers. In the past, my first payment I ever made was through PayPal because at that time, that was what I felt most comfortable doing. But now Trade Assurance is the only way to go. I love it and it's so easy. So this definition says, Trade Assurance is a free service offered by Alibaba.com that's designed to help create trust between buyers and suppliers. Trade Assurance covers you in the event of shipping or quality-related disputes. So essentially, what this is Alibaba, the platform, holds onto the money. So you're going to make a bulk order of, let's say, 500 of these. So let's say the payment is $700. You send $700 to the platform of Alibaba, and the supplier does not get that money until you receive your items and you tell the platform everything looks good, and then they get their money. So it's the safest way for the buyer and the seller to both feel comfortable with the transaction. And then the definition for a verified supplier is a supplier's company profile, production capabilities, products, and process controls have to be inspected, assessed, and verified by independent third-party institutions to assure reputable and consistent expertise on Alibaba.com. So these suppliers have been checked out, their products have been checked out, their quality control has been checked out, and they're good to go. It's not just a supplier that has been on for 3 months, doesn't care about their products, and they're just looking to do some business real fast. These suppliers have have been on for a while and they are very reputable. So I really wanted to start off with that just so you guys know that there are a lot of really good suppliers on there that you can have a relationship with, you can do business with, and have really good communication with. Now, I will say a lot of times I will have people ask me, you know, I know that a lot of these suppliers are from China. Is there kind of a language barrier? And there kind of is, but kind of isn't. Everybody is different. Some people, their English is better than others, but most of the suppliers that I've talked to, their English is pretty good and we are able to communicate totally fine without having any issues. Also, something else that I wanted to talk about, a tip for you guys, don't get your hopes up when you're seeing the prices listed per piece of what you're looking for. So let's say you see that this is listed for 25 or 50 cents, you'd probably have to purchase a couple thousand for it to be that price. For me personally, I think I paid $3.20 for this, and this was including the shipping cost and the little engraving on it. So if you didn't want the engraving or if you wanted to purchase a higher amount, I don't think I purchased that many at once. I think I only purchased about 200, but if you're wanting to purchase over 1,000 or more, you are going to get a lower price per piece. So this is why what I recommend for you guys to do if you're looking to get some more information about pricing for whatever your item you're looking at, doesn't have to be wick trimmers, whatever it is that you're interested in learning more about. So what I would recommend for you guys to do is to chat with the supplier. Now, if you're looking to chat with a supplier, keep in mind that if you live in the United States, the time difference is between 12 to 15 hours depending on where you live in the United States. So me personally on the West Coast, I typically like to start a conversation between 7 and 10 p.m. because I know that it is going to be a early to late morning time for them. And most of the time I get an immediate reply. Whereas if I were to message them at 8 or 9 o'clock in the morning, it is way too late. Nobody's at work. So you have to do that waiting period versus actually having a conversation live with the supplier. So what I typically say when I go to chat with a new supplier for the first time is I just start out with giving them as much information as they need to give me a quote as quickly as possible. So in the beginning, I kind of started off little by little asking separate questions. Now I pretty much just start off with all the information that they would need. So I say something like, hi, I'm interested in purchasing your wick trimmers. Can you please tell me the price per piece for 500 of them? Also, I'm looking for door-to-door shipping to this address. Editing Erica here, and I just realized while editing this video, I did not explain the shipping at all. So I just wanted to real fast go over that with you guys. Now, I will say I am not an expert when it comes to Alibaba shipping. I have only ever done door-to-door shipping, which I believe is when they ship it by air. So I think there's multiple different kinds of shipping that you can do, but the two that I'm most familiar with is what's considered a door-to-door shipping, which is what we are typically used to when we are making a purchase online and it comes right to our door. I believe they either use DHL or FedEx when delivering packages, or even UPS. I think it just depends. And then there's also sea shipping, which is, I believe, when you have a really large order, specifically when it's really heavy and it's cheaper in shipping, but I think you have to go down to an actual seaport to pick it up. Again, I'm not too sure about it. I just wanted to add this in here that I'm most comfortable with door-to-door shipping, but it's best to do a little bit more research to see what the best option is for you. Now, most of the time I will give them my full address because I've given so many different suppliers my full address and I have no issues with that because that's how they can give me an accurate quote. However, if you are a little bit nervous about that in the beginning, I believe that you can just send them your city, state, and zip code, and I think that it would be just fine. But for me personally, I just send them my full address just so they can get an accurate quote, because you guys will be so surprised on how expensive the shipping can be, because again, most of the time this is being shipped from China to us. So it's going to be very expensive, especially in very large, heavy packages. It is going to raise the price per unit by a lot. So that's why if you're wanting to negotiate anything, it's really good to negotiate the actual item that you're wanting to purchase, not the shipping, because I don't think that they can be negotiated on the shipping as far as I know. But all I know is for the price for the actual item that you're wanting to purchase, I have negotiated the price down by a couple of different things that I've purchased before. So I know that it's possible to negotiate. So once you have your quote for how much it's going to cost you for the items and your quote for the shipping, then you can add those two together, divide it by the number of pieces that you are wanting to purchase, and then determine at that point if it's going to be worth it for you to purchase that item. There have been a few times where I've wanted to make a bulk purchase from a supplier, but I wasn't able to get the price down low enough to make sense for me to go through all that trouble to purchase it overseas and get it in bulk when I could just spend a little bit more and get it more local online somewhere in the United States and have it be an easier process for me. So that is something to consider if you are wanting to really buy in bulk and you're wanting to spend a lot of money to order something overseas to get the price down a lot lower than you can get somewhere local or somewhere online in the United States, definitely go for it. But it's a lot of back and forth, and it's not so much that you are going to go with the first supplier that you talk to or the first item that you're looking at. I have spent months and months and months before searching for the perfect thing that I'm looking for. They can also customize things for you. So it's a lot more of a process to go through it, but it can be really exciting to be able to purchase things in bulk, know that you have all those at once, and also if you're looking to customize something, because these suppliers, a lot of them are manufacturers, so a lot of them can make things specifically tailored to what you're looking for. Something else that I wanted to mention in this video is to pay attention to the minimum order quantity. So for some suppliers, the minimum order quantity per unit is really low. Like let's say it's only 100 items that you need to purchase in order to meet that minimum order quantity. Whereas other suppliers, their minimum order quantity is 1,000 or 5,000 or 10,000 I've seen before. You have to order 5,000 or 10,000 units in order to meet the minimum number of units that you need to make that bulk purchase. So all suppliers are different. However, keep in mind, like I was saying before, if you're going to purchase something in a smaller amount, it is going to be a higher cost per unit. And then that's where you need to weigh, is this going to be beneficial to me to make this order, go through all of this trouble, and then only save maybe 10 cents when I could order from a local website and be able to get it a lot sooner and only spend a little bit more money to get it. Also, don't be afraid to chat with multiple suppliers for the kind of product that you are looking to purchase. There are a lot of different suppliers for the same kind of product, so you can kind of search around and talk with multiple suppliers, get different quotes, because different suppliers will charge different amounts for the same kind of item that you're looking to purchase. So you may find that there is a supplier that is charging a little bit less and you might want to go with them just because, let's say, the shipping is a little bit cheaper, or they're willing to negotiate a little bit more on the actual price of the product. And even if you save $50 to $100, that is still better than nothing. And when you go to make the final purchase for your bulk order, Alibaba does have a fee to use their platform. So a lot of times I will strategically try to bring down the cost of something even by 10 or 20 cents. And that way I will save that $50 to $100 and I will be able to have that essentially cover the fee on Alibaba to actually make that transaction. Okay, so once you are happy with talking with your supplier, you've gotten your quotes, you like the product, and you like the pricing on how much it's actually going to cost you per piece, you've done the math to figure it out how much it's going to cost per item that you are purchasing, then you can ask them for a sample. I never, ever, ever want you guys to order 500 or 1,000 units of something without getting a sample first. All of these suppliers are more than happy to send you out a sample. Most of the time they say it's a free sample, but then you pay for express shipping. So express shipping, in my experience, has cost me anywhere from $30 to $50, just depending on how big your item is, how heavy it is, all that kind of stuff. So I think it's well worth it to spend that money on a sample, wait for it to come in, test it, check it out. You can even, I think, ask for two samples just to guarantee the quality and the consistency of it. Some suppliers are a little wary if you're trying to purchase more than one sample, just because I think that they might be thinking you don't actually want to make a large purchase and you're just wanting to purchase multiples of that one item. But I highly recommend for you guys to ask them for a sample and get that set up right away, just so they can get it shipped out to you right away. I think I've gotten a sample in as fast as maybe a week out, which is really quick coming from China. So a lot of the times when you're paying for that express shipping, it's well worth it for that item for you guys to check out, make sure it is good to go before you actually make that bulk order. And then from there, you just wait for the sample to come in the mail. If you like it, then you can make that bulk order. If you want to change some things, or you want to customize some things, or you need to test with it more, or whatever it is, then you can kind of negotiate a little bit with the manufacturer, the supplier that you're talking to, and see if there's anything you want to change or customize or whatever it is. A lot of these suppliers are, again, more than happy to see what you're looking for, customize it to your liking, because they're wanting to build that communication and have you as a lifetime customer with your business, so you keep coming back, ordering more from them, and then you can order more at a time, maybe get cheaper prices later on down the line the more you can order. So it's just kind of a win-win for everybody. And then the last thing that I want to help you guys out with is just some tips on what I've learned when I go ahead and place the bulk order, because this was the part that, again, is most nerve-wracking when you're spending all this money. But essentially what the process is when you are chatting with them and you've had your sample in, they know exactly what you want to order, I just will kind of reiterate, okay, so I want to make a purchase of 500 of these wick trimmers for this specific price right now. And I actually didn't know how Alibaba Trade Assurance worked in the beginning. So I didn't know if I had to set something up or if they set something up. But essentially what it is as soon as you say you want to make that payment, they will go over and create the payment for you on Alibaba, and they will actually send you a link in the chat for you to click on, and you go and pay it. It's really, really simple. It's really easy. And depending on how big your order is or how much production is needed, they may need to make two different payments. So if your total for everything is $1,000, they may say put 30% down before we make your item and then finish it off with 70% of your order. So start off with $300 down and then you finish it up once your order is complete and ready to ship. But unless they say otherwise, it is just going to be that one payment. So as soon as you process that payment through, the only other thing that they will need from you is to make sure that they get your full name, your phone number, and your full address. Don't be nervous about giving them your phone number. They're not gonna call you. I've never had one person call me. It's just what they need to actually be able to ship out your items to you. I believe it might be a customs form kind of thing for shipping overseas. But I believe that is all of my tips and everything that I've learned from personal experience of working with multiple different suppliers and kind of learning as I go along, learning kind of the consistencies from supplier to supplier. So I really hope that I helped you guys out, and I hope I eased some of your worries, because I've had multiple of you guys reach out to me about seeing some products that you like on Alibaba, but you don't know how it works. You're kind of nervous to get started with it and you don't really know how to do it. So I really, really hope this video helped you guys out. I love talking about this because I love how much more I've learned since the first time that I ever placed an order with them. So I just love talking about it. So if you guys have any further questions, comments, anything like that, feel free to leave them in the comment section below, as well as subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to follow me over on Instagram at memoryboxcandleco. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys. Brody can't stop barking. I know. There's a lot going on outside. I understand. I fully comprehend why you're upset, okay? So today's video topic is going to be all about getting these gnats. I just kind of wanted to quickly Alibaba Trade Assurance is the platform's guaranteed money exchange thing. Cool. That made a lot of sense. Oh! Your little howl is so cute.